Listening Library presents Mabel Jones and the Forbidden City by Will Mabbitt. Read for you by Mark Heap. Chapter 1. Fetch her, my foul creepers. Mabel Jones scratched her armpit thoughtfully and peered through the bars at the extraordinary creature before her. It's a funny-looking thing. All wrinkled and fat and helpless, like a beetle grub, kind of slimy, but kind of cute too. Her baby sister, Maggie, snored gently and blew a snot bubble from her left nostril. Babies can be quite disgusting, thought Mabel, absent-mindedly picking her own nose and wiping her finger on the wall. Especially when you have to share a bedroom with one. She yawned, climbed into bed, and fell asleep. Totally unaware that something quite dreadful was about to occur. Which, of course, is why we are here. Slide open the window and squeeze inside. I think we're just in time. We wouldn't want to miss any dreadfulness. Creep silently to the wardrobe and press your grisly ear hole trimmings to the door. Can you hear the distant sound of drumming? A frenzied beat. It grows louder. And louder still. Oh, what's this? Chanting too? Just when I thought it couldn't get any worse. This must be some kind of witchcraft. I don't like this. I don't like this one bit. Far, far away, a long fingernail scrapes along the words of a letter. A letter written during a previous, most unlikely adventure by the very same Mabel Jones we see now safe and snug asleep in her room. A letter, bottled and corked and thrown over the side of a pirate ship into the rolling seas. For months, it bobbed on those waves, years maybe, until it washed up on a faraway beach to be found, swapped, sold, stolen, then lost and found again, before it finally reached the hands of this strange and wicked creature. Cracked and painted lips silently mouth the words of the letter. Then the fingernail pauses as it reaches the end of the final sentence, where an accidental memento has been left. A single hair, a Mabel hair, is carefully removed from the letter and sniffed. Fresh, snuglet. Fresh enough for dark magic. The grim smile widens to reveal ancient, crumbling teeth. The drumming has stopped. The chanting has died to a soft murmur. And now a voice speaks in soft yet cracking tones, like honey poured thick on burnt toast, whispering an incantation. Fetch. Cha, my foul creepers, bring me the one called Mabel Jones. So brace yourself, for a wicked seed has been planted, and though its roots are firmly embedded in the future, its shoots and vines are winding through the hot and steaming mists of time into the present. Quickly! Press your puny weight against those wardrobe doors, child. You must prevent this foulness from occurring. Alas, it is futile. Your scrawny body's no match for the strength of dark magic. It's time for the secret weapon. Have you brought the powdered beak of a heartbroken swan? Quickly, mix it with your vial of hedgehog tears to make a paste. Then mark the sacred sign upon... What? You don't have either of these things? Really? 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 Then all is lost. A thin, white shoot sprouts through the gap between the wardrobe doors. It grows fast and strong and splinters the wood. A vine has formed. The vine branches. Its branches branch. Then those branches branch some more branches. And the branches of the branches of the branches branch once more until the room is filled with curling vines. that wrap and twist round bookcases and chair legs, pulling all they find closer to the open doors of the wardrobe like the tentacles of a starving octopus. Up the walls they creep, across the ceiling they wind, all searching for one thing. Fetch her, my foul creepers. They reach the bed. Bring me the one called Mabel Jones. A vine curls beneath the duvet, questing for the sleeping Mabel contained within, gripping round her ankles, tightening round her wrists. Then, with evil purpose, the creepers tuck the duvet into place. Mabel is wrapped up, still snoring, like a sausage roll made with girl instead of pig parts. And slowly but surely the bundle snuglet is pulled towards the wardrobe. Who knows what lies in store for a young girl stolen from her bed by the foul creepers of an evil enchantress? Could this be the end for Mabel Jones? A toe, poking from beneath the duvet, catches on a line of thread stretched tight above the floor, looped round a nail hammered into the skirting board, then stretched upward and tied to a precariously balanced tin of coppers. Ka-ching-a-ching! A booby trap, set by clever, resourceful Mabel Jones. She has had some experience of unlikely adventures such as these. If you've been snatched from your bedroom once, then it pays to take great care it never happens again. Mabel Jones was woken by a sudden noise. She'd been having a strange dream that she was being dragged into the wardrobe by the tendrils of an evil creeping vine. And then she realised it wasn't a nightmare. It was really happening. She opened her mouth to scream, but a thick vine covered her face, smothering her cry for help. Mabel, a skilled vegetarian, bit down hard and tore off a fleshy chunk of plant with her teeth. Vile and bitter sap filled her mouth, like she'd just swigged on a bottle of knit lotion. The bitten vine recoiled, spilling sap on the bedroom carpet. Mabel bit another vine, and her arm was free. Free enough to grab a nearby shoe and use it to hammer at the vines that dragged her towards the wardrobe. Vine by vine, she fought the plant until she was sitting in a pool of mushed and mangled stems. The creepers were retreating now, shrinking back into the wardrobe. The spell was broken. Mabel sat panting in the remains of her bedroom. My name is Mabel Jones, and I am not scared of anything. But something is wrong, Mabel. Something precious is missing. Something very precious indeed. My matchbox full of toenail clippings. 4 years' work gone. And something else, Mabel? Oh, and the cot is empty. Maggie is gone! Mabel's sister, sleeping soundly, stood no chance. Plucked from her cot and dragged into the wardrobe, along with a Tupperware box of Lego, Mabel's recorder, and of course the toenail clipping collection. Look! The final vine is disappearing back into the wardrobe. Mabel leaps to stop it. Maggie Jones may well be a slightly inconvenient and annoying baby sister, but she is Mabel's slightly inconvenient and annoying baby sister. She grabs the vine, and for a moment she holds it fast. Give me back my sister! Then the vine tugs, sudden and swift, and Mabel falls forward into the wardrobe. Into a hot, steaming mist, her fingers still gripped round the end of the tendril. Somewhere in the distance, the familiar sound of a wailing baby can be heard. Maggie! Then the vine snaps, weakened by the earlier bites of the desperate Mabel Jones, and she is falling, falling away from the cries of her baby sister, falling into darkness. And then, with a thump, she is back in her wardrobe. Actually, this isn't my wardrobe. This is the inside of a completely different wardrobe. Chapter 2. The City of Broken Dreams. If you sail across the wild western sea until the water warms and turns an emerald green, you will eventually reach a land that stretches as far north and as far south as the eye can see. Welcome to the New World. So, anchor your ship, drop a dinghy in the gentle waves, and row to the beach. And when you're there, let us walk.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.